This is the broadcasting service of Smartcut Entertainment Movies and Documentary.
Acknowledge her for supporting you. I listened to you on the internet where you were presenting the Look, oh wait, it wasn't this one.
Yes, it was this one.
Okay, it was this one, yeah. I listened to it. I almost cried. Because it reminded me of Obama when Obama was reading his oath. So I said, this is just our talent. This is our brother doing this, you know. So I really want to appreciate you for what you have done. And maybe as time goes on, you'll become the millionaire that you're going to be. It might not pay off right now. But as long as the books are in bookstores, people will be reading them and they will be reading them. So thank you for what you have done and thank you for what you are doing. And one day, one of these books, I'm sure, will be on the big screen where you, you know, sign big contracts.
And Thank you
for leading way. Just before she gets to her seat, let me just tell her, just, you know, something about writing books all these years and having been able to finish it. You don't become an author. You don't become an author until you actually have the discipline to sit down and start writing. Comfort Yanin will tell you that, Ben Amucho will tell you that, Stanley here will tell you that. So, but then the day you finish it and you want someone to take another look at it, please give me a call. You know, give me a call. Yes, and I will look through it and I will edit it for her. As a matter of fact, it won't be me misleading you guys to say that I edited Ben Amucho's story. I did. And not that I'm bragging, I have a lot of story I have to tell you about that. I met Ben Amucho a few years ago, but I've known his brother way before. And for some reason, he called me up and said, look, can you take a look at this book? I said, okay, I will. And I usually charge people. And sometimes I don't, depending on the interest I have in the story. So when Ben gave me the story, I said, okay. I looked at it. I told Ben, this is a good story. I told Ben that I would not charge him originally. But when I read it, and I saw a great potential that it had. I told him, listen, I mean, it's a big book. I know I love you, but I gotta judge you, bro. Let me tell you what happened. He told me to meet him in a coffee place. I did. So when we came to the coffee place, I told Ben, the only reason I'm not charging you, the only reason I'm not charging you what I should charge you is because each time you've seen me in a party, you bought me drinks. That's what I told you. So I've always taken from them. And I said, listen, because it's a big book, I'll charge you a minimum of what I usually charge you. After I told him the figure, what I wanted to charge him, you know what he told me? If I had stayed with the original figure that I told him, he would have paid me that. Amen. You know? But it is such an interesting story, and I'm talking about Universal Donor. It's such an interesting story. And I'm not saying it because it's here or because it's good, he wrote it. I am telling you this without any qualms, that this is one book. After you've read it, you will believe, you think that it wasn't written by an African or whatever. But then it is. It is such an amazing book. So, Pauline Webiko, if you ever have to have that book edited, give me a call. And I can tell you, and everybody's listening here, I won't charge you.
I was born in a little village called Tsomo. Our huts clung to the side of the mountain, which was so steep that when there was a wind, I expected them to be blown into the valley at least 100 miles below. My mother was a Xhosa, my father a Zulu. The women had to do all the work because the men were so busy being big, strong, and brave. It was a happy time because we always seemed to be singing and dancing.
Yeah.